Hey, what's up guys, welcome back, you're watching for today. Google has started to roll out their Android 16 beta 2 builds for their Pixel series devices. Android 16 development is on the peak and the final public build will be available by the June 2025. But why do it when photo tech is here? Today we brought you the early test of this newly released beta 2 build of Android 16 for any Android device running above Android 10 version. I got the custom GSI of this build and is booted on my OnePlus 9RT using the DSU side loader. This method is the safest way to test all the custom GSI without breaking your device. You can also use such GSI as a dual boot with your primary stock ROM. You will find a video tutorial link for the complete process of flashing and dual booting in the icrad. Today in this video we are going to review the new Android 16 beta 2 build with its all new changes in comparison with the old beta 1 update. At the end I discuss some bugs of the GSI for OnePlus 9RT, so you will get idea how the GSI build is. So watch this video till the end. Now without further ado, let's get started. As this is a beta of GSI build, we will get the stock AOSP boot animation. After the first boot, you may get the weird square-shaped dock and the app drawer icons, which is normal thing for such AOSP GSI, but you will find how to solve this at the end of this video. So everything is sorted out, now let's check out the about device details. You will not find any major overhaul in the settings panel of Android 16 as compared to the Android 15 build. In the about device section, new beta 2 showing the Android 15 version as baklava. In the easter egg, you will get this new Android 16 logo with the same spaceship game of Android 15 with some minor animation changes. Maybe with final release, Android 16 may get something different. Security patches of these beta 2 builds are of old from December 2024. Except that everything will remain same as your primary ROM if you are using the custom GSI build on your device. Let's check out what's new thing we get in a beta 2 in comparison with the old beta 1 build. First change in Android 16 beta 2 is some icons were placed in the circle. As I am using the GSI with the custom launcher, it's not completely visible. But you will get the idea with the screenshot of the icons, how it look like. For color contrast setting, old beta 1 maximize text contrast setting is now renamed as the text outline. But function of both the settings are same. It will highlight the system text with the white or the black background as per the theme of your device. Under the setting and the system, in the language and the region option, we get the new measurement system option. This one was not available in the old beta 1 build. This will help all the user or the system application to use your regional preferences of measurement for your device. Currently, it's only showing the US and the UK imperial measurements, but in future, more regional support will be available for this setting. Instead of this, you can also set your own region, temperature preferences, even the first day of your week, because it also varies as per the different regions in the different countries. Next, under the system and the gesture setting, we got the new action of wallet access along with the camera for the double press power button setting. So you can quickly access your Google Wallet anywhere using the double pressing your power button. Next, new Android 16 beta 2 has added the pure black theme for the QoS panel system and the app setting background, while old beta 1 didn't have the pure black theme. Next, for the face unlock setting, we get the new face recognition animation. This is not fancy, but still, it's a new change I got for Android 16 beta 2. Next, in the Android 16 beta 2 has added user switch widgets. You can check that in the screenshot, but I didn't found this widget in my GSI ROM. So these are all some minor changes are there in the new Android 16 beta 2. I flashed this custom GSI on my OnePlus 9RT. It's booted fine. It has most of the things working like Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, NFC, GPS location. Almost all the sensors are working along with the mic, earpiece, ear proximity, display, etc. But still, some bugs are the major, like safety net is failing and the Google Play Protect integrity got passed for the basic integrity check only. So you cannot able to use the banking or the payment application in this beta custom GSI build. But remember, for the Pixel devices with the official beta builds, they are working without any issues. For OnePlus 9RT, I didn't get any network detection because of no baseband is detecting in the GSI. Even fingerprint sensor is not working. Face unlock setting is available, but it's buggy. Except these other things are working. As I told in the beginning of this video, when you first time boot this custom GSI, you will get the stock quick-step launcher as a default launcher, which will have such weird square-shaped icon for the dock and the app drawer. But you can set up your account in the Google Play Store and can install any third-party launcher like launcher, and can customize the look of app drawer to the pure Google style. Remember, these bugs may vary as per the device you are using. Some devices may or may not face all of these issues. So you have to test this latest Android 16 GSI on your device, which has the ARM64AB partition scheme along with the dynamic system. You can simply test all of these Android system features as a dual boot with your primary stock ROM using DOC loader. Remember, this will not boot on Nothing Phone 1, but it will work on the OnePlus 11R and 12R. We have to test it, and please let us know in the comment section, is it booted for your device or not with the device name. That's it for today guys, hope you liked our work. If yes, then please do like and share this video, subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon for such amazing content. Thanks for watching, see you next time, take care, bye bye.